Violent waves hurl and spin you. Something slithers around your ankles, seizes you with incredible strength, drags you down into silty depths. Now, is this really happening, or am I seeing a vision or a memory of someone's past, or what? When the pulling stops, you are hovering at the center of an endless blue abyss. You can see neither surface nor floor. You seem to be facing downward, but there is no way to be sure. A voice sounds from everywhere at once, and the immense pressure wave of each utterance sends you reeling.
Deceitful wretch! Grave robber! You who dig for that which you did not bury! Speak! Explain yourself and be judged!
It's Ondra. Who are you calling wretch, wench? I was looking for the privy. Might as well be blunt and honest. I seek a means of defeating an army that threatens my lands.
You seek what is mine, what was rightfully lost.
The outburst propels you, sending you end over end. I don't think there was any good answer to that you would elect.
Your actions speak for themselves. The battery opened, the forge ignited.
Yeah, and?
You set free souls that hid from me, that stole from me and evaded my judgment.
Well, now they're not hiding from you, right? You can go get them.
The dwarves sealed their own fate. The forge was meant to be forgotten. And now, here you are again, denying peace to the buried.
The turbulence around you calms. Silt settles like a slow exhalation, and the vast, dark seascape beyond the murk fades in. Rays of light trickle down from far above onto green-gold columns of kelp that rise from the depths and sway back and forth in the current. Fish and mollusks patrol them in groups of hundreds and thousands. The nearest pass you with watchful eyes. What do you mean the forge is meant to be forgotten? Was it a matter of something is remembered or forgotten? It's in the past. What are the bones of one god doing sealed in the temple of another? And the army that destroyed the dwarves. Really curious about 1 and 4. What do you mean the forge is meant to be forgotten?
It was never meant for mortal use. Such power, such truths lie within it. It can bring only ruin.
Well, at least she sounds a little more calm now.
When the Pargrunin came to the White March, they were peaceful. They shared common beliefs and purpose.
Oh, she sounds nice now.
Their visions for the forge tore them apart. You have seen this for yourself.
True.
They would have destroyed themselves in the end.
I see your point.
I mourned the loss of the Pargrunin. Misfortune brought them here. They did not deserve to end so soon.
I'm actually curious about 3 as well. Two is a stupid thing to say. Obviously it's remembered now, so it's not in the past anymore. It's being used now, right? The army that destroyed the dwarves, the Eyeless, are they yours?
What the world casts aside, I take into my care. A thing may be forgotten, but it is never alone as long as I am here. They were lost children, abandoned. Fixed on a purpose that no longer had meaning. I took them in, gave them new purpose. I did not create them, but yes, they are mine.
What new purpose did you give them?
Some things that are forgotten must never be remembered.
So we've forgotten their purpose. Wait, you gave them a purpose. But we have to forget about it. I feel like we should be addressing her, like, more reverently. Like, your lord, your lady lord, your goddess ship or something?
not merely for the benefit of those who forgot, but for the entire world. There can be no second thoughts, no sympathy or stays of execution.
For who? The Eyeless or me?
The Eyeless were born to fulfill this task, though even their creator did not know it. They are single-minded and relentless.
They kill those who remember what you want forgotten. You mean they kill those who remember what you want forgotten?
They do not flinch when called upon to do what is necessary. Kith owe them a great debt for the troubles they have hidden away.
They are Abadons. I saw them forged.
They were his once. I won't deny it. He created them as assistants to carry out his work on Eora. But he has long been the overseer of progress in the world. Leaving things behind has always been his way. I allow him to leave his past in my care, so that it does not hold him back.
Well, that's nice of you. You and Abadon have a unique connection, then.
I suppose we do. But then, the gods have always been able to accomplish far greater things when working together.
Nearby, you see a shark pass through a school of fish. The fish scatter, evading the predator. All the changes in her voice are really interesting. I had something else I wanted to discuss about the Eyeless. I'm not sure if there's anything else.
Speak your mind.
You haven't given me the whole truth about the Eyeless, have you?
Careful what you accuse a god of, mortal.
The water around you is suddenly icy. You can feel it sap the heat from your veins. Let me go back and ask some other questions before I lock myself off here.
You may ask.
What are the bones of one god doing sealed in the temple of another?
Do not play coy with a god, Watcher. I know you have seen his death. I feel it whenever a forgotten thing is taken from me. Abidin did not deserve to die here. This place... It was the least I could do to give his remains some privacy.
So he is truly dead forever. A dead god, wow. The least you could do? Just making sure my mic is still on. Sounds weird.
The least I could do for ending his life.
Light drains from your surroundings. The kelp forest becomes a copse of black tendrils, stark and twisted as regret.
I called the moon down to me, Ioni brother. It was against his wishes. He would not listen to me. In his madness, he splintered the moon, but it was not enough. The greatest of the fragments still fell toward that which he would protect. In the end, he took position where it would fall, and absorbed the impact himself.
I thought Balafa and Caldwa were the moons, how you say that?
Ioni brother is their smaller sibling, tiny next to them.
A third unknownst of moon. Small enough that the world would survive its impact. But why the temple? Why the secrecy?
That time has been forgotten now. And so his death belongs to me. Everything he was before the impact.
But you slew another god. Surely the other gods know this. Surely Abadon must know. Well, isn't Abadon the one who's dead? Current surges through the kelp bed, pushing each plant sideways like saplings in a hurricane, and propelling you backward again amidst a torrent of wayward fish.
No! He cannot know! He must never know! Understand, he was not always as he is now. His body was not all he left behind.
So it's just his body that died.
He was devoted to progress and industry from the beginning. But so too was he devoted to preservation.
understand. Is this god still around or what?
In those times, he would let nothing go. Nothing could be forgotten. His will was iron long before his body.
What was it he was trying to preserve?
Time has finished much of what I started. I cannot tell you that, mortal, for fear of undoing all its costly work.
Preservation. So that was why he went so far to oppose you.
We agreed long ago, all of us, not to alter the course of Kith's civilization. Not directly. Not unless there were no other choice. But in this matter, there was no other choice. He understood that as well as anyone. It was for duty that he opposed it. I would have stopped it if I could, but by then it was too late.
I don't think I should say this.
You may ask.
Why did you pull down Aeoni Brather?
The great conundrum of a god is how close to become with your subjects. Too far and they lose hope. Too close and your own judgment fails. Civilizations are meant to ebb and flow. Allow them to persist for too long in power or knowledge, and you invite catastrophe. There was a time when we let our sympathies get the better of us. When memories were allowed to persist that should have been washed away.
Well, we know Ondra, all about washing away those memories.
The other gods could not be moved to act. I did what had to be done without them.
You're talking about the Ingwithans.
I speak of what is forgotten. I failed that day, but my purpose was achieved in the end. I will not dredge up the memory to satisfy idle curiosity. The great conundrum of a god is how civilization... There was a... The other gods could not be moved to act. I did what had to be done without them.
You were too close to a civilization? Which do you speak of? Well, the Ingwithans, right?
I speak of what is forgotten. I will not dredge up the memory to satisfy idle curiosity.
What does it matter if something is remembered or forgotten? It's in the past, in either case. Stupid thing to say, but I'll say it.
Memories are the spirits of the past. You of all people should know their sway on the present, Watcher.
I'm perfectly sane. Perhaps more than I'd care to admit.
Mortals measure the worth of their lives in memory. Who will remember me? How long until I am forgotten?
No frickin' idea.
Memory governs every thought, informs every choice. It can fuel passion, understanding, love. Or it can create obsession, madness. You have seen it plague many souls in your travels.
Indeed I have.
Consider the old Watcher who inherited unspeakable crimes from birth.
Meerwald, right?
Or the young woman who committed herself to Brackenbury for love of things she remembered she had.
I know she's talking about, I forgot that name.
Or the Glamfellen boy for whom an old medallion was worth more than all the fruits of his labors.
I've forgotten that one.
Or the former Crucible Knight, whose political embarrassment embittered him against the organization whose ideals he treasured above all.
Again, I remember that one. And, forget his name. We killed him.
They could be free from their burdens, if only they could forget.
Their problems go deeper than memory. Simply forgetting does not make them go away.
For some, perhaps. But for many, the memory is all that remains of it.
The light filtering down from the surface seems to focus on Mineha.
You cast your troubling memories aside when you had the opportunity, and you have found the peace you sought.
She probably doesn't remember what you're talking about.
It's funny. I remember feeling bad, but I don't remember why. It's like having scars for wounds you don't remember. As long as they don't reopen one day, I can live with that.
The source of those wounds is long gone. The memory was all that could do you harm.
Interesting options. There was value in the memory, despite the harm.
Even when problems have run their course, memory can be the stone that sinks you into the abyss.
Well, if I want to anger her, I need her help to call off the eyeless. Really tempted with the Intellect 17 choice, though. Engenders an incomplete conception of good that it fails to consider the importance of testing the soul. I'm still not sure I agree, but no matter.
Your past has not overwhelmed you yet.
Yeah, we're getting there.
Wait.
Huh?
Was there something else, mortal?
Yes. I need you to call off the eyeless.
On the contrary, mortal, their work must continue.
No.
Far too much was uncovered while they lay dormant.
They draw attention to the very things you wish hidden. In my dreams, I have seen them swarming over the Deerwood.
Those who know too much of the White Forge will be washed clean from Eora. And then the eyeless shall rest once more.
This isn't some lone tribe of dwarves. The Forge sees visitors from all over now. The eyeless will tear the Deerwood apart. It will never be forgotten. The sea life around you stirs back and forth, agitated, restless.
Even if it is as you say, there is nothing that can be done.
What? You're a goddess.
The eyeless do not think for themselves. They have only the purpose that is given to them. They do not stop until the purpose is fulfilled.
Then destroy them.
They will not change course now, for me, or anyone. I am sorry.
Kaoto said they could be called off.
Only if those they pursue are no longer a threat. The Raid Sarens were stopped before they could take the White Forge. In your case, Watcher, you are well beyond that now. And if what you say is true, then the Deerwood is as well.
This was your doing. You must intervene.
The interventions of gods seldom work out in anyone's favor. Our touch is too heavy. The world crumbles beneath it. It is why we so often enlist the help of mortals. They execute our wishes with greater care.
She's not getting rid of them. How many of these freaking things do we have to fight?
I have done far too much already.
If you won't stop them, then I will.
Your determination is commendable. But the eyeless number in the thousands. You will need more than strength or luck.
The help of a god would be most welcome.
I will give you what aid I can. I bade the eyeless to remain hidden when at rest. They are gathered in the hollow of a great rock, splintered from Aeoni Brother. It lies in a flooded crater known as Cairn's Scar.
Okay.
Know, too, that they were built to answer the call of their master's hammer. When they hear it strike, they come to its aid. If you were to take that piece of his hammer from here and reshape it in Abaddon's Forge into a likeness of the original, you might be able to call them to you, but destroying them would be another matter.
I can't fight thousands of these things.
I know of one way, but only from the center of the lion's den. Only with their master's hammer in your service.
The center of the lion's den?
If you can do all this, if you can reshape what remains of Abaddon's hammer and bring it inside their lair, I can instruct you there on what you would need to do.
It would be easier if you told me now.
Nothing I say will make sense until you see it for yourself, mortal. We share a common purpose now. I will see you through it when the time comes.
I will remake this hammer in the White Forge and stop the Eyeless.
On the contrary, mortal, their work must continue. Far too much was uncovered while they lay dormant.
What? You said you were going to help me.
Those who know too much of the... Even if it is as the Eyeless do not think for themselves, they have only the purpose that is given to them. They do not stop the interventions...
Wait.
It is why I have done far too much already. Only if those they... In your case, Watcher, you are well beyond that now. And if... Speak your mind. You may ask. If you do not be assured, they will come for you as they did for the Pargrunen.
I must have pressed the wrong number or something. An uneasy turbulence disturbs the calm like an unwelcome thought.
Careful as you approach the lake. When I claimed the Eyeless, I made sure they would not be discovered while they slept.
Something's guarding them?
Many of my most devoted followers stand watch there. They will not allow you near.
Then they're all gonna die.
And there is something far worse. Something more fearsome and dangerous than any Eyeless.
Oh, God.
Let us hope you do not attract its attention.
You can't just add that in there casually. What is it? In place of an answer, a sudden surge in the current from beneath sends you hurtling upward. The surface above you approaches fast, shifting and glimmering like quicksilver. You emerge soaking wet on the stone floor of the reliquary, gasping for breath as if you'd been holding it for hours. Atop the Abbey of the Fallen Moon, I found the reliquary and the answers I sought. The Eyeless are the army of my dreams. They will destroy me and thousands of others to protect Andra's secrets. Oh no, they won't. Andra has said that the Eyeless are gathered together in a fragment of Aeoni Brather that lies in Cairn's scar, and that there may be a way to stop them if I can reach this place. However, Andra has advised me that I'll need to recreate Abaddon's hammer first in order to be able to summon them from their deaths. With the fragment of Abaddon's hammer I retrieve from the Abbey, I have enough metal to make a Kith-sized version of the original. Andra believes this will be adequate to be able to hold sway over the Eyeless. So we have to fight those things in those, we have to make it first, and we have to get to that zone. We have to fight those things. Whatever the guardians are. The people and the thing that's worse and that hopefully we do not come across. I communed with Andra, who advised me that the Eyeless will not relent until everyone with specific knowledge of the White Forge has been killed. That includes a great many people, including me. She believes that if I were to reforge the hammer of their creator Abaddon from a piece of the original tool, that it could be used to destroy them. The White Forge will enable me to shape the fragment into a likeness of the original. Now, I don't suppose we could have everyone come here and go in the waters to forget, you know, the memory. That would be another way. Too many people, right? A wreath of ashes. In the Valian Republic of Palminia, a military graveyard has been struck by vandals that burn tributes left for the dead. Though troubling to the Duchess, she has few local resources to deal with the problem, as the Republic will soon be celebrating the 50th anniversary of the Battle of Lagone Perella. The Duchess would like to have the mystery solved quickly and quietly. Quickly and quietly. Why does that sound familiar? Have Canna go. Canna's awesome. Okay. Now can we go see what's up here?
Nice and quiet.
Travel directly to the foundry in Durgan's Battery. Sure. Alright. We're gonna make this hammer. Somewhere down here is a camping supply. I think I might have taken it though. I don't know if I could just make this thing. Yeah, I guess I took it. Or if I need more Durgan steel. Incredible heat ripples upward from the white forge and laps against your exposed skin. The fragment of Abaddon's hammer grows warm in your hands as if in recognition. It is only a fraction of the size of the original, but there is metal enough to create a hammer fit for a person of your size to wield. In this forge, the fragment could be shaped anew. Recreate Abaddon's hammer. You call to mind every memory you have witnessed of the great hammer. The images coalesce and take shape in your mind's eye. You know every curve, every engraving. Even as a shapeless lump of metal, you can see the fragment for what is meant to be, what it is meant to become. The fragment is slow to heat, even in the White Forge, and quick to cool as you work it against the anvil. Sweat drizzles down your body and puddles at your feet. Your arm grows sore with each swing of your forge hammer until you can barely lift it. Minutes turn to hours. As Abaddon's hammer begins to take shape, the ring of your own hammer against it takes on a familiar tone, one that you have heard in your dreams. Yeah, I heard that. With each strike, an image flashes in your mind. It is hazy at first, but it gains detail as the hammer begins to resemble the original. Over time, the image becomes a frozen landscape centered around a crater lake. Eyeless patrol its frozen surface in droves, and this can only be the place Ondra described, Karen's Scar. The eyeless pause here and there when you strike and look up, as though hearing the echo on the wind. I thought I had to go in the lion's den. In the distance, as more details appear, you can see other landmarks. Stalwart, Durgan's Battery, and you understand where the lake lies in the White March. Where you must take this hammer. Yeah. Finally, with the careful etching of the last detail with your chisel, the hammer is completed. No sooner do you make the final mark than you feel a pure, radiant energy pulsing from within it like a mechanical heartbeat. There is an indescribable beauty to the shape and the weighing, the weighting and the design. It feels as if this is the realization of the metal's purpose. You take up the hammer and its power rushes over you in waves and shakes your body so hard you nearly drop to your knees. The tremor passes, but the surge of power remains. The hair on your arm stands on end. In your hands is a faithful recreation of a divine instrument. Careful with the weapons of the gods, Watcher. They seldom come without strings. Who are these guys?
I've heard enough.
Darien? The sounds of an argument reach you from the stairs. Darien marches into the room, arms crossed, while Wengra bounds along behind him.